Annual State of the City address, Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson painted a picture of a city that is trying to move boldly into the future without leaving anyone behind. But he also said Cleveland faces a stark choice between a tax increase or layoffs. Fox 8's Bill Shield joins us with more on that. And Bill, why is the mayor saying that it has come to this?
Well, he says they're about $63 million short permanently now, a permanent $63 million a year loss in funding. Those losses, the mayor says, stem in large part from lower property tax values, sharp reductions in money the city gets from the state, and the loss of revenue from red light cameras. So without a tax increase, this is what Mayor Jackson says the city faces.
The only thing left for the city of Cleveland to do in 2017 is to lay off employees and to cut or eliminate services.
Now, the mayor also proposed a change in investment strategy that calls for $25 million to be pumped into neighborhoods to help with quality of life issues. He also touted the importance of education in moving people forward, saying it is critical for voters to renew an operating levy this fall. But he said given the budget shortfall, the city can't cut its way to prosperity with layoffs and reduced services.
That is why I am proposing a 0.5% increase in the income tax that will give us $80 million, which is enough to cover the gap between costs and revenue, thus making us structurally balanced and giving us the capacity to purchase additional service that we will need for the future.
Mayor Jackson said while he doesn't agree with all the findings about Cleveland police in a scathing Justice Department report, he does agree that reforms are needed. The mayor signed a consent decree with the DOJ last year that calls for sweeping reforms, but will also cost millions of dollars.
A lot to talk about today, and we know how important education is to the mayor. What did he have to say about that? I mean, are we moving in the right direction?
Well, he thinks so, and he believes that we are with the Cleveland Plan, as it's called. It is his passion. His signature issue, of course, is education, but all anybody is really focusing on today is the potential for a tax increase. The mayor's had a lot of credit, gotten a lot of credit for keeping the budget balanced during these years. He sort of says we can't close the $63 million gap without finding the money somewhere.
Did he address at all? I did a story recently on painters getting, there's a job opening for a painter, $85,000, and then benefits. It was probably a $100,000 job. So things like this, waste, fraud, abuse, contracts coming up, maybe you only need $40 million in a quarter percent tax increase.
He did not address into that deep. He didn't dive that deep. The text of his speech doesn't go that deep. He's basically saying that the cuts, the red light cameras weren't anticipated. The cuts in funding from the state were not anticipated. The property tax, you know, we've seen the decline, but I think if they were a little short, they could find ways. But he didn't say, could we close the gap more? I think they'll propose the 0.5% increase, and we'll see.
No easy solution. All right, Bill.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.